Bundy's Garage, Bundy here. Today I wanted to do an update video on the heat soak problem. I know there's a lot of confusion about that out there, and a lot of forums it says it has to do with fuel vaporizing in the rails, and I have to disagree with that. Just due to the fact that you've had your car for probably over 7, 8, 9, 10 years, and it's just happening now. If this was a problem from the get-go, it would have happened from day one, if you actually truly think about it. So something has changed inside the vehicle. The one thing that I know that actually worked on two vehicles that I've worked on is this sensor right there, the engine coolant temperature sensor. It's not going to throw a code, so it's about $30 from O'Reilly. What you need to do is just go ahead and replace it. But one thing I wanted to suggest to everybody that they try to do is there's a clip on the backside, right? So get that out of the way. 19 millimeter sensor. So just break that loose. If you can, I might have to get a wrench and a socket, I mean. I took a 19 millimeter wrench from Home Depot and cut it in half, as you can see right there, because on the Acura TL that I was working on, there was no room to be able to get this in, and I didn't want to take the plenum off and everything else, so I snuck it out, basically. So, but on this one, I'm going to have to get a 19 millimeter socket and break it loose that way. So let me grab one of those, and I'm going to show you something else. I have a 19 millimeter socket here, 3/8. Drop that down there. Go ahead, bring this down, and break it loose. Okay, once you take this out and replace it, what you want to do is you're going to want to go ahead, take some coolant, green engine coolant, because that's what these Honda Acura J-Series V6 engines take, and fill it up. Fill it all the way up to the top, where it's almost spilling out. And if it spills out a little bit, no big deal. Because what I have found happens on these is the fact that customer parked at work and then came back out, it was hard to start, and it was a very specific angle that it was at when it happened. So what you want to do is fill this up. If it spills out a little bit, no big deal, but you want to make sure that there is no air pockets in this system right here. And as I was saying about the person who only had this happen at work at a very specific angle, is the fact that if air is stuck in here, then it's going to leave the sensor naked or not submerged into the coolant, and then you're going to get a false reading. And that's probably another reason why this is happening to you. So it's not a heat soak problem on the Honda or Acuras. It's a coolant temperature sensor problem. Just make sure that when you do replace this, fill it up with coolant before you install the sensor. Hopefully this will help you guys in fixing this very frustrating problem that only happens every once in a while. It actually, what happens is you'll start noticing it. It'll maybe happen once a year, then it happens twice a year, and then it starts happening, you know, 3 times in 6 months, and it'll start happening 6 times in 1 month. It just gets progressively worse and worse and worse. When you replace this sensor, go ahead, fill up the sensor hole with coolant just to top it off. If it spills out, not a big deal. You can use water, but yeah, it'll just get progressively worse as time passes. And it's not a heat soak problem, and it's not a fuel vapor locking problem. I know guys are talking about that inside the fuel rails, but if it was, it would have already happened from day one. It doesn't matter if it's summer gas or winter gas, it just doesn't vapor lock. Cars nowadays, specifically on Hondas and Acuras, they were not going to vapor lock on you. That's in carbureted, old style cars. This system is tuned far enough, and Honda knows exactly what it's doing to not let that happen. So like I said, when you replace this sensor, go ahead, top off the coolant here before you replace it, making sure that the sensor is actually submerged and that there's no air pockets in there. It's best if you do this cold. Another thing you can do, if you don't want to take the intake off like I've done here, is you could actually be very careful when you do it and use a rag, but you could actually, when the engine is warm or hot, you could actually crack this and then put a rag over there so you don't burn yourself, but crack it while it's warm, and then coolant will start to come out, and that way you know that there's no air locked up in this section of the housing. Quick tip for you on the heat soak problem. If these videos have helped you out, please subscribe. Questions, comments, concerns, you can email me at bundysgarage@gmail.com. And like always, I'll keep them rolling for you.